this is Nene Bassey, I'm reporting on behalf of the CEO Africa. We are at the venue for the conference organized by the Faculty of Pharmacy, University of Ibadan. And today is the second year of the conference. The conference is titled Improving Quality to Access Medicines Through Propositions and Legislation. With me is
I'm a hospital pharmacist.
Okay. Madam, I'd like to ask, yesterday, today, what has been your experience so far?
I'm glad that I've come for this conference because we have actually been able to see so many policies that are in place for making good quality medicines available for to Nigerians. The Ministry of Health, their own guidelines, the regulatory agencies, their own guidelines, even African Medicines Agency, and what even donor agencies are doing. So we've been enlightened on a lot of work that people are doing to make sure that Nigerians have access to good quality medicines.
Ma, so far, do you think with all the propositions and the documents put forward since yesterday, do you think the international organizations will be able to come up with strategies to curb the infiltration into Nigeria of substandard drugs?
We discussed the issue of substandard drugs, and there are actually many regulations already in place in Nigeria to ensure that the drugs that are available to the population are of good standard. There are still hindrances that we still have are in the place of implementation of some of these policies. The policies are in place, but what sanctions are there for those who flout these policies? What do we do? What punishment do we give to those who flout it? And then how do we even monitor or evaluate how much we've done or what impact the policies have had? I think those are some of the challenges that we have been able to learn at this conference.
Okay, ma'am. So as the PCN, as a body, what do you think can be done on the part of the PCN to promote drugs, as in to promote the manufacturing of drugs made in Nigeria? Because as it stands, it's like most of the orthodox drugs we have are imported. So what efforts is the PCN, the Pharmaceutical Society of Nigeria, what efforts are they making to make sure we have standard drugs manufactured in Nigeria?
In the regulatory agencies, in the past, they go to inspect the premises for manufacturing. And they have said that now that they are even also encouraging cottage industries. So that they don't need to have a big building or everything, especially for those that are manufacturing on small scale. But they have said the challenges that people have are in the area of technology. A lot of the equipment also coming from abroad. Although they are encouraging organizations like FIRO to also manufacture, and so that we can use this locally produced technology to produce the equipment. So I think the regulatory agencies are already partnering with other organizations to make sure that at least if the equipment are locally manufactured, and that will reduce costs and reduce the foreign exchange needed for equipment from abroad. Also, they have also complained that they also mentioned that they have some challenges in the area of funding as well. They are also short-staffed. We talked about the few pharmacies that they have. They're actually working with them, also private, some volunteer pharmacies when they are doing, for inspection. For instance, Lagos State, the zonal coordinator for Lagos State, has said they have only 8 pharmacies that are working with them, for Pharmacist Council of Nigeria. We can see that is actually inadequate to monitor drug use in Lagos State by the agency. So we know that they have talked about inadequate funds, they have talked about inadequate staff, they have also talked about some of the laws that there is no sanction. That the sanctions are there, but nothing to. The policies are there, the sanctions are there, but it's like nobody follows up on how to on punishing those who deviate from the set down standards.
Now, if we are going to have documents put forward after today, people will submit propositions. What steps will be taken to help? I don't want to say enforce now, because enforcement is not supposed to be by the PCN. is supposed to be from the lawmakers. Now, what effort is the PCN going to make, put on the legislature to make sure that there is strict out punishment for those that are importing substance abuse? Because we have a lot of reported cases. Like one of your participants put forward yesterday, some people react to drugs differently, maybe because of the components of a particular drug. So, and then if we look into it deeply, we could equally find out that it may be as a result of a substandard drug, you know, put in a case of a standard drug, but it is substandard. So what effort is the PCN going to make sure that these propositions that are going to be that will be passed forward today will be put into place, and so that we can reduce mortality rate?
One thing that I want us to correct is that adverse drug reactions are not necessarily from counterfeit medicines. They could actually be from good quality medicines, but because we are different individuals, some people react, you know, differently to some chemicals. You know, the drugs are chemicals that we take into our body, so people react to them differently. So the genetic makeup of people is what makes one person react to a drug and another person not react to a drug. But you have also said, I mean, quite rightly, that we have many counterfeit medications in the country, and regulatory agencies have told us is that they are creating awareness. I think if you create awareness, even up to National Assembly level, and people know that the health of the nation is very, very important. It is a healthy nation that is a wealthy nation. And if everybody knows that, we need to safeguard our health and the health of even the Nigerians that don't even know. Well, in the rural areas, babies, you know, mothers, there are many people who don't even know, who don't even know how to go about getting, good quality medicine. So we need to create awareness. The National Assembly must know that it is very, very important. We need to increase, they have also talked about us also, advocacy, you know, for the National Assembly to also allocate more funds for healthcare. As it is, the budget for healthcare is too low for over 170 million Nigerians. It is too low when we compare it to allocation for other things. Even the Ministry of Health is cash strapped. Everybody seems to be cash strapped. But we know that if we advocate, and the National Assembly is also aware, our legislators are also aware. I know that they have a lot of things, you know, to see to, but they should also give priority to healthcare issues. And if they do that, they will know that they will have a vibrant and healthy nation, everybody will be able to contribute to national development. Again, if they also encourage, local production, which the Honorable Minister of Health has also said several times that we need to encourage local production of medication. The Vice President also said it. And so if we encourage that, it will contribute to our economy. Very good. So I think awareness and then also allocating more funds to healthcare.
Thank you very much, madam. We quite appreciate your time. We wish you very successful.
Thank you.
Thank you.